All right, guys, welcome again for another video here. This time I actually made the video. If you haven't seen the other one with the JavaScript, HTML, CSS, this time I'm actually using Angular. I'm making a pagination. So it's the same thing, but just using Angular. The one I'm using right now is currently Angular 16. I know they have a later one. But yeah, if you haven't seen the other one, it's you can go to my channel here and you can actually check it. But yeah, this one here is using Angular and this is what we're going to be working on. So let's start working on it. Let's open VS Code. You have to, of course, download Angular if you don't have it in your computer. So I already have it, already built an already built the application. So let me go ahead and start coding. All right, guys, so I have cleaned up, removed the unnecessary files, and I also have imported the HTML here. So I have the headers, it says the users. I have created the divs, one here, one another one here, and I'm using a class, an ID. So I also imported the CSS from my GitHub. So the only thing we're going to be focusing is working on the, over here on the app component TS right here. So this is what we're going to be working on. But let me show you what it looks currently right now, what it looks like. So this is what it looks like. I already put the style so we can focus on the TS files. So this is what we're going to be working on. So let's go ahead and get this going. So the first thing I want to do is I am going to go ahead and create over here. I'm going to name this. It's going to be list items. And this one is going to be a type string. And let me make sure I have it right here. And it's equal to the array of names. So let me go ahead and copy that from my GitHub real quick. So we don't have to waste time on that. All right. So we have that. So then I want to create two more variables here, which is I'm going to declare this one's going to be called current page. And this one is going to be a type number. And this one is one. And we also going to need the rows. And this one's going to be type numbers. And this one's going to be equal to 5. So here we're going to create a function. This one is going to be display list. Okay. And so here inside there, we're going to pass page, and that page is equal, is a types number. So again, here we're going to create a variable, which is going to be called constant star. And this one, we're going to use this rows, and we're going to multiply that by the page. Kind of similar to the one I did in JavaScript. Okay, so then page minus one. And then I'm going to do another one. It's going to be called constant n. And this is going to be called, this one I'm going to do is star. And I'm going to add it by the rows. This rows. And then I'm going to do return this list items. And I'm going to use the slide operator. And then I'm going to do star and n. Okay, so that's it for that one. And then here, the next function I'm going to create is the one for the, I'm going to call this one the pagination. So this one is going to be called set pagination. And this one is going to be, I'm going to create a constant page count. Page count. And this one, I'm going to use the math seal. And I'm going to put down the list items, which is this list items. And I want to get the link. And I'm going to divide that by the rows. And then, of course, I want to return the array. And then I'm going to do that from the link. I'm going to pass here the link and the page count. Page count. And here we're gonna pass I'm gonna pass I, which is the index. Oh, I messed up there. And we're gonna use the arrow function, and this is gonna be I plus one because we want to make sure it starts at one, not a zero, when it starts counting. Okay, and then we can go ahead and go back to the HTML here. And inside here, see like how you guys, I have a class list, and then also I have the ID. So there I am going to do the, here I'm going to do the ng4. So there's going to be div. I'm going to do ng4. There it is, like that. And here I'm going to do let item of display list. And then I'm going to pass here current page. And also I am going to pass, let me see. I'm going to pass here items like that. And also I'm going to give it a class of item like that. And if I go back to the screen, I should be able to see something there. Oh yeah, see, now I see it. Cool. So that's that. So the pagination, let's go ahead and add up the pagination. So here we're going to add up a button. And here what we're going to do is we're also going to do the ng4 again. So let me see if it's working button. Let me just work over here. Yeah, see, it says button on it. All right, but let's do it dynamically. All right, so we're going to go ng4. ng4, and I'm going to do let page of the, what do we call it, setup pagination, and inside there we're going to pass class like that. No, it has to be inside parentheses like this. It has to be like that. Class acted. And if it's equal to current page like that, it's equal to page. Let me see. So then we got to pass the click event. And here's, we've got to pass the on page. Well, we got to create that. So we got to do on page. We're going to name this on page change. So every time you click it, it will change to the next one. So in here, we got to pass parameter, which is page. Here we got to pass page. Of course, it's not going to work. Here, let me take this out for a second. I want to see if the numbers come up. Let me see one second. Let me go back to, okay. So it's, yeah, see all the pages are coming up. But of course, it's not working because we haven't added up the unchange event. All right. So let's go ahead and create that. So let me go back. All right. So let's go see right now. It's complaining about it because we don't have it. So we got to go back to the TS, and we're going to go ahead and create that function real quick on that. So we're going to go down here. It's going to be called onPage change. Make sure it matches the one in the HTML. And here we're going to pass page. And it's going to be type number. And this one is going to be this current page is equal to the page. So now we should be able to change the pages. That's it. See, simple. I know. It's less code than just doing in vanilla JavaScript, but yeah, this is how you do it in Angular. Pretty cool. Just less stuff, and then this is the CSS, and here's the HTML. Here, that's it. And all right, guys. But this is it. Hopefully, you guys found this video helpful, so you guys can apply it to your projects. stay tuned for more. And this is one of many videos to come. All right. And don't forget to subscribe. Make sure you share the video and leave a comment in the bottom of the video. I'd like to hear your opinions, even if it's a bad one, but no worries. Anything counts. And again, stay coding. Stay safe, continue coding, and I'll see you on the next video. Take care.